Hey Sam, where is the best place in the world to kitesurf? Well, I've been travelling to the best kite spots on this planet for the last 15 years, and I've really struggled to give you just one place. It depends what you want.
Do you want perfect flatwater lagoons to land your best freestyle tricks? Or maybe long downwinders with your friends for as far as the eye can see? Or do you want to drive down the beach and get your buggy stuck? Or maybe big air's your thing? Or perhaps you like waves? And you want to throw the biggest mega loops of your life. Or maybe you want to explore the Caribbean on a 95-foot yacht, sit in the hot tub with a couple of babes whilst flying your kite, and hydrofoil in the clearest water you've ever seen. Or maybe you're into long, epic downwinders, jumping land gaps, sliding on docks, riding down channels, and hucking yourself off kickers. Or maybe you want a unique action sports town where you can snowboard in the morning, kite in the afternoon on a river in fresh water. Or perhaps you're into tropical islands, luxury hotels, and the most perfect point breaks you've ever seen. You might want somewhere close to Europe that's definitely going to be windy and cost effective. Or maybe you want somewhere in Europe that's rich with culture, has amazing flat water, and you don't mind riding with loads of windsurfers. Or maybe an English-speaking country that's really far away from Europe. Or somewhere right on your doorstep that's perhaps a little colder, not quite as consistent, but boy, when it lines up, it's as good as anywhere in the world.
As you can imagine, it'd be really hard to pick just one of those places, and that is the beauty of kitesurfing. I'm also slightly biased towards freestyle, big air, and foiling. I'm not much of a surf guy, so please take my list with a pinch of salt. This is based on my own experiences where I've had the most joy kitesurfing around the world. But without further ado, let's get into my top 10, starting with number 10.
My local beach in the UK just had to make my list. I've had so many amazing sessions down on Hayling Island. We have a unique 2 km sandbar that stretches out into the ocean, that creates great waves at high tide, and then at low tide, we get some amazing flat water either side of the sandbar. However, it's quite fickle and inconsistent, but if you're there at the right time, it can be as good as anywhere. Hayling Island also hosts the Kitesurfing Armada, which is one of the biggest events in Europe and definitely worth checking out. Number 9 on my list is Dakhlar in Morocco, or Western Sahara as the locals like to call it. If you don't mind hotels in the middle of nowhere and nothing else to do other than kitesurfing, then this is the place for you. You're almost guaranteed wind and waves at the right time of year. It's close to Europe, but it can be a pain in the ass to get to. Dakhlar has some amazing conditions and is definitely worth checking out. Number 8, Doprano, Greece. This is an amazing flat water spot that gets really consistent wind during the European summer months. However, the spot is quite small and does get really busy with both kite surfers and wind surfers that are extremely grumpy. So if you don't mind riding with lots of people, then this is a great place to check out. Hood River, USA holds a special place in my heart. I've spent loads of time there and for good reason. It's so unique kitesurfing on a river in fresh water far away from the ocean. They get really consistent wind, they host great events, and they have one of the few public kite parks in the world. This is the ultimate action sports town. It's just super expensive and busy in the summer. Number 6, Safety Bay, Australia, otherwise known as The Pond. This is another special flat water spot that gets really consistent wind during their summertime. In fact, the whole of Western Australia is an amazing place to kitesurf. There's very consistent wind, great waves, it's just really far from everywhere, so you kind of need to go there for a long time. Oh, and it's also quite expensive. Number 5, Cape Hatteras. The Outer Banks has some of the best kitesurfing in the world. I've had some of the most amazing downwinders riding down channels, jumping massive land gaps. There's also great waves if you want to surf every day, and it's an awesome place to learn to kiteboard. Real War Sports have a very professional operation. They used to host the Triple S Invitational, which somehow I managed to win 4 times. The one drawback is it's far away from everywhere and there's not much else to do. Mauritius, wow. This is an amazing tropical island in the Indian Ocean. I went there for the first time last year and was blown away by its beauty. They get consistent wind that's good for freestyle, learning and foiling, but the main focus in Mauritius is the waves. One Eye is one of the most perfect point breaks you will ever see. There's some amazing hotels right at the kite spot on Le Morne, so it's a great place to take the missus. The one drawback is it's quite expensive. Number 3 on my list is a boat trip in the Caribbean. Yes, I've included the whole of the Caribbean, but there's something really, really special about being on a boat for a week exploring a different island every day. I've had some insane experiences aboard the Wind Voyager's 95-foot cat sailing around the Caribbean, accessing places you wouldn't normally be able to kitesurf. The wind tends to be a little bit lighter and favours hydrofoiling in the Caribbean, but occasionally you get a couple of babes in the hot tub. Number 2, and just missing out on first place, is Cape Town, South Africa. It's got really popular over the last couple of years, with a lot of people planning their holiday around the King of the Air. There's great waves, and a unique combination of cold, dense wind results in the biggest jumps and kite loops you will ever do in your life. The only downside is it's not the easiest place for beginners. Number 1, Brazil is without doubt the best place in the world to kitesurf. It's the only place I go where I don't check the forecast. It's so much fun driving down the beach in your buggy and getting stuck to then find the most perfect flatwater lagoon you've ever seen and landing tricks you never even thought were possible. Brazil has so much to offer from September through to December, but it's not all about the flatwater lagoons. You can do some of the best uninterrupted wave downwinders for as far as you want to go. Brazil really does have it all, from flat water to waves to long downwinders and strong wind, which is why it's top my list and the reason you need to check it out. I've learned some of the best and most beautiful places to kitesurf are also some of the hardest places to get to. Kitesurfing is incredibly diverse and it's such a good way to travel and experience new places and cultures. So I urge you to get out there and explore.
So that was my top 10. What do you think? Am I missing any destinations? Do I need to go anywhere else? Please let me know in the comments. But I'd recommend doing your own in-depth research into each destination because they all vary so much. But thanks a lot for watching. Please subscribe if you're not already. Smash the like button, it all really helps. Hit me up in the comments if you want any more help with any of the locations. But yeah, thanks a lot for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next video. Peace out.